Hello, my name is Carolina Short and I am a senior tutor at the University of Waikato in New Zealand.
Hello, I am Tomás García Ferrari and I am a senior lecturer at the University of Waikato in New Zealand. The present work is an attempt to bring back ideas and approaches produced in the middle of the 20th century at the HFGE Ulm, and contrasting them with contemporary sustainable design practices and discourses. We identify that there is a neglected area in present design discussions concerning a historical acknowledgement of the HFGE contribution to what is nowadays called sustainable design. Our work aims to broaden the current knowledge of the influence of the Ulmer Institution in this area.
Mobility and transportation are key topics for sustainability. Transportation contributes to economic growth and trade opportunities. As a reliable and safe transport system helps to integrate the economy with the environment. Both people and goods need constant flow in order to operate, and an efficient transport system improves social equity, health, the connection between rural and urban communities, and the exchange of resources.
At the HFGE Ulm, designers were presented as coordinators in the development of a product, from its conception to its final delivery to the client, assuming the responsibility of their practices. The designer's profile, defined at the school, was of an agent of positive change, in consonance with the definition provided by Simon years later. Everyone designs who devises courses of action aimed at changing existing situations into preferred ones. Products designed at Ulm tended to present a long-life design. They avoided the addition of non-functional features and ornaments or decorations. Objects with the purpose of being consumed and discarded had no place in the school's program.
Also, placing the need in the core of the design process leads to the optimization of resources and puts human life as a central concern. And that was the case at Ulm. To analyze and identify sustainability of products, we will use some methods and tools suggested in design for sustainability approaches. This provides a technique for boosting an environmental observance, systems and services. They promote efficient energy use, they encourage recycling, and they consider all the social benefits related to usability, fair trade practices, and social responsibilities. Sustainable design methods have the goal of decreasing the negative impact of human activities on the environment. Among the numerous terms and methods that connects with the notion of sustainable design, we can name green design, eco design, and later on cradle to cradle, design for the circular economy, among others. And those terms and methods have some parameters that are related to them, such as reusability, renewability, recyclability, longevity, low emissions, and multifunctionality. Another important consideration is the need. Although the perception of need can be subjective and dependent on the context, there are essential categories to meet human needs, such as transportation, resources, education, textiles, healthcare, etc. The ways these needs are fulfilled and how the resources are applied to the purpose can vary, and this is where sustainable design can contribute to improving the equation. Ulmer developments and sustainable design examples. The Ulm School of Design has developed some iconic products that gave the institution a worldwide recognition, such as the Brown Electronics, that became archetypical and created a style with a name. German design. It was converted into the standard, and it was associated with features such as practicality, rationality, low cost, and neutrality. However, the school also took care of essential topics on the development of a fair society, such as the design of traffic systems. In 1967, the school participated in the Expo 67 Montreal, invited as one of the world's 18 best design schools. The exhibition panels that were taken to Montreal were on methodology and transport systems. These projects presented at the Expo did not belong to the school commercial development groups. The projects presented were performed during the classes given by the teachers that were concerned with actual topics related to human needs and social developments, and that were far from the interest of an electronic consumer brand. The school was not only the producer of a German style or a brown style, as their interest revolved around cities development, transport systems, and the problems arising from these matters. There was at the time a crucial concern about the transport expansion, in which design had an extensive responsibility that touched all disciplinary areas, such as in industrial design, signaling system, vehicle design, railway wagons, and other supported products ranging from petrol pumps to street lights. In the building department, they were concerned with traffic-related structure, such as bridges or parking lots. Even in visual communication, they were working in new traffic signs and transit campaigns, etc. In the 50s and in the 60s, the means of transport experienced an explosive growth. The development brought new complex demands on design, and those changes were reflected at the HFG. As a result, all of these projects, such as signaling systems, utility vehicles, truck bodyworks, etc., were carried and were regular exercises at the school. The bus stop shelter was one of the iconic projects developed in the area of transportation that showed a flexible construction system that consisted of two independent structures, the roof and the wall elements. The wall elements could be used to create protective walls, and they were flexible and adaptable to the different needs. They were plastic elements, they were easy to assembly, and they had also low transport costs. We can compare the HFG Ulm shelter project to a contemporary sustainable design shelter. Benjamin and Stedman created a product that was aimed to be for public use, for everyday use, and the concept of need was the trigger of the selection of this project. The project was compared to existing London shelters using the software Sigma Pro, and it resulted in less than 10% of the environmental impact of the actual shelters in use. The shelter is part of a transport system with the possibility of moving a vast number of passengers per day, bringing several advantages to human well-being and the reduction of emissions. The overall benefits of this new shelter designed by Benjamin and Stedman were substantial, particularly in the saving of emissions. Both the overview of health, ecosystem, and resources analysis and the impacts on human life score very high for this design for sustainability shelter. It followed a sustainable, all sustainable design approaches. It was suitable for London streets and intended to last at least 30 years. The selection of materials also encouraged people affection by providing general seating, lighting, information, security, etc. The modular system will have also a good fit for any road characteristics, allowing a customizable configuration according to the needs. At the HFGU Ulm also, the use of systems was one of the approaches to design. And this is an actual sustainability concern that urges that an integral problem-solving approach is part of should be part of the design project. The only alternative to efficient sustainability is a system perspective, because many things are interconnected, and all those connections must be addressed in the design task. This viewpoint involves financial, social, and environmental concerns. To understand a system perspective, one must think of a system as a whole, considering all the factors which contribute to a particular activity. In Ulm, the design disciplines were practiced based on planning and systematization. Some of the projects developed there show systemic approaches, like, for example, the tableware or the food packagings that granted the advantages of stackability, easy washing, modularity, standardization, and reusability. To conclude, as we were saying, transportation is one of the main concerns in sustainability issue, as well as the use of systems. And these were topics that were highly relevant and extensively discussed in Ulm, as we have shown today through the examples of these projects. New and complex challenges open to the design real, and these echoes were heard in Ulm. This brief recap from some selected work by Ulmer students and teachers show how objectively the concept of design contained a sprout of sustainability. Those projects did not bring out environmental concerns that were not present at the time. However, austerity, multifunctionality, use of systems, obsolescence awareness, and research practice were considered. The flexibility and the diversity exposed in these examples are characteristics asked of sustainable products. Not having used the term, sustainability was part of the design definition that the school proposed, with a program that included social equity, resource optimization, and respect for the planet and the environment, which are now considered main pillars of sustainable design practices. The connection between sustainable design ideas and the Ulmer Institution could offer a different approach to current design practices. Questions and problems from past decades are contributing to the creation of a culture of sustainability in design. Looking at the questions held decades ago, we understand that they are also relevant today. Finally, this conversation could lead to the creation of more desirable futures. Thank you.
As a final note, we invite you to read our paper and be in contact with us if you have the interest of continuing these discussions. Thank you.